Thank you so much for inviting me here. I really want to thank the organizers. This is a great conference. And it is a great conference because I've seen how the panelists are really presenting their views in a really honest way, without sugarcoating or without giving in to hype. So many times we talk about Spanish in the U.S. and we try to exaggerate or basically say that Spanish is gonna take over English in the United States, and it's not so. However, we're important, and Spanish is a really important language in this country and in the city I live in. Gerardo said in his presentation, I host and produce a political weekly show on New York One Noticias. Its name is Pura Política. And I think it's a really good example on how Spanish media can play an important role, I think, in the US. It's a really small show and a really small local news channel, but it was created in 2005 just because New York One News, that it's the number one local news station, cable news station in New York City, decided in 2005, since there was a Hispanic candidate in the race for mayor, that it was interesting to have maybe a political talk show for Spanish language New Yorkers. It was a good time for that. So that's how in 2005 Pura Política started as a weekly half-hour show. Now we are 1-hour show every week. So it's a good example because whenever a politician in New York wants to talk to the Hispanic community or to the Spanish language community, they come to our show, and we're really happy to have them. So much so that they also want to come on the show sometimes just because they want to show off their Spanish skills. They're trying to learn Spanish. Sometimes they come with their cue cards, and they're so cute in a way because they want to make sure that after the whole interview in English, they read that cue card in Spanish, look into the camera, and you go like, really? They look a little bit childish. Anyway, it's a really good show too because all of a sudden we became so popular that many people are writing to us saying, I don't understand your show. You should have subtitles in English. I'm like, okay. I thought about the show for Spanish language speakers, and now all of a sudden all these English language New Yorkers, they want to understand what we are saying. And also we have politicians who they say, I don't know if that's true or not, they are trying to learn Spanish, and they take the lessons, and then as an exercise every week they watch our show. So that's really exciting. Anyway, let me start talking about how, even though that's important and even though Spanish is growing in the US, when we talk about Hispanic growth, that doesn't equal Spanish growth. I do think that right now at this point it might be we might be reaching our peak in Spanish speakers in the US, just because even though the Hispanic population is going to keep growing, it's going to keep growing more with US Hispanic born than with new arrivals are still coming in fewer numbers lately, and those are the ones who really need information or media in Spanish because they can't speak English, or maybe because they have really rudimentary English, or because when they watch television or they listen to the radio or they read the newspaper, they rather read it or have that information in their native language. So I do think that we are reaching right now our peak, just because those new immigrants coming to this country, we have fewer numbers, and maybe another group from another country, from another culture, is going to substitute all those Latin Americans coming to the US. Now, it's really important, Spanish is really important, but like Reina said in the previous panel, it's a second class language. And sometimes we forget about that. Sometimes I forget about that when I work for a Spanish language news station. It's a second-class language because many Latinos, and rightfully so, they don't want their children maybe to speak Spanish. They think that if they don't learn proper English, they are not going to be successful. Or if they have a slight accent, that might make them less marketable when they become professionals in this country. So it's a language that people speak in the house. It's a language that people in the shadows speak, or that those people in the kitchen that I don't know who they are, but there's someone in the kitchen in New York, and of course, many of them are Mexican or from any other Latin American country, that's what they speak. But it's such a separate reality from the mainstream reality of the US that it's really hard to make Spanish competitive with English in the US. And like I say, like accents can be really nice. I come from a city where everybody has an accent. However, when you go to a job interview and you have an accent, people might see you differently. They might think that that's really cute, but you're gonna go to that corner because you're not an English native speaker, maybe, and you are not part of the mainstream or the first division, so to say. What's the social role that we can play as Hispanic or Spanish language media? I think the main battle, and we know that, that we are fighting or that Hispanics are fighting in this country is immigration reform. I think that's the most important battle for many different reasons. One of the reasons is because you have a huge population in this country that lives in the shadows and that can be part of the mainstream of this society just because they don't have immigration papers, because some people say that they shouldn't be here. So until we have some sort of immigration reform that pull those people out of the shadows and put them in a path to some sort of citizenship or residency, we are losing a big chunk of the Spanish-speaking population in this country because they are down there. And since they are down there, they have some sort of professional or income ceiling that is stopping many companies from investing in that community and also stopping them from creating a strong advertising market that could sustain media in Spanish in the United States. That's a huge issue for Spanish language media in this country. It's just that how you create a network of advertisers that can sustain your business. Because at the end of the day, this is a business. Now, it's also important immigration reform because that way those people who live in this country, who love this country, who work in this country really hard and who don't think about going back, they can't really participate in political life. They can't really relate to politicians. They can't vote and they can't have a voice because if they have a voice, someone is gonna pull them over and they're gonna ask for an ID and maybe they're gonna be in risk of deportation. Now, two more minutes. Okay, I'm gonna rush. So you have to, in order to really grow, in order for the Spanish language or Hispanic media, that could be in English, in order for that section of the media pie to grow, we need to legalize Spanish, so to say, if you allow me to use that expression. Legalize Spanish versus all those people out there, and we have a few now running for president, trying to make English the official language of the United States. And just to finish, I think there's a huge opportunity for countries like Spain, Mexico, Argentina, or Colombia. They have a huge opportunity to invest and build a strong, competitive Spanish language news business in the US only and only if they know how to make it happen in this market. The Hispanic market in the US, it's really complex, it's really diverse, very fragmented, and it doesn't have anything to do with Spain or Argentina or Colombia or even Mexico in certain ways. They have to understand this market that is really complex in order to be successful and to build a strong US Spanish language market. If they don't do it, Anglo-America or Anglo-United States is not going to do it because the money in the short run is not there, so they are not going to invest in the long run, and that's necessary to really build a strong media in Spanish in here in the United States. Thank you very much.